Hey guys, my name is RockHead and welcome back to another video. So lately I've been playing a lot of esea, but the problem is just I've been doing really bad recently, where I'm getting like 5 kills in one game, or maybe like 10 kills, but a higher death ratio. Well, not higher death ratio, just more like a fucking 0.5 death ratio basically. And honestly, to tell you the truth, I went from B minus all the way back down to the current rank you're seeing right now. The reason why I'm back into C ranks is because the lack of practice, and it's just, oh my goodness, it just affected me so much. So mainly the reason you want to warm up before every game is stress tests your aim to the point where you have your aim and reflexes on point, and it also gets you mentally right inside the game. Stress testing your aim just means that you are basically warming up your hands to shoot every single person that you're going to see in battle, whether it's Battlefield, Counter-Strike, Overwatch, Call of Duty, or any other FPS I can name at the top of my head that I played in my past. If you think about it, it's almost the same thing as like you're doing stretches before any sport like football, baseball, basketball, or anything like that. You want to like stretch your muscles so that way you'll be at your full potential. And that goes the same thing with warming up in a video game, where you're just warming up your hands or thumbs if you're playing on controller, and it helps you like play at your full potential. The second point of warming up is just mentally gets you in a game. For this one scenario, if you're like coming home from work or from your ex-wife's house and you're just upset, angry, anything like that, you want to get your mind off it, it's really going to help you just warming up, so that way you don't have to have that thought process in your mind while you're playing, and just make sure you're really focused in the game. Now, warming up is not the only way of just keeping your skills up to point. It's just you want to like also watch pro matches. Also, if you're solo queuing, I recommend you just dry run your maps. Maybe like find the best solo route that's like best for you. I used to do that in Call of Duty so many times, and that pretty much helped me for what I need to do in each map. Also, you can also brush up on your smokes and flashes, or just utility in general. That's really going to help, because like map control is really important in any FPS game that you know of. Also, if you really want to just, if you feel like you're over aiming or under aiming and you're not doing so well, even if you're doing all those things, try a new sensitivity. Or if you're on PC, try a new DPI. That's, and then like see if that's going to like work better for you. And also like for, if you're like defending, like if you're playing objective based games, try like new positions, try like power positions. That's really going to give you the easier kill. And that's about it on the video. So what you're seeing right now is my warm-up routine, is where I play on aim and reflex map for CSGO. I'll leave it in the description down below. And this map really is my best friend when it comes to aiming. You can shoot every single bot that you see, and I recommend just going as fast as possible and reaching at least 200 kills to 300 kills, as long as it's like about 10 to 15 minutes. So that's all I got for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please leave a comment down below if you want to discuss anything. Please like the video if you really enjoy it, and also subscribe if you want more content. I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much.